left. He said, stand over your grave. The words took a moment to register. When they did, Herod lost all the rest of himself that was sane, and ordered the soldier's throat cut at once. Even repeating such a thing was an act of treason. And so, the two soldiers who'd helped their battered comrade kneel, now threw their blades from behind. The giant, for his part, didn't resist. Not as his brothers dragged their daggers along his neck. Not even as he saw a spray of red cover their arms, or felt the warmth of blood running over his chest. He'd known the moment the Antioch ghost had chosen him as his messenger. He'd known he would never leave Herod's throne room alive. The giant fell forward, feeling as if his head were full of wine. A moment later, he couldn't remember his own name. A moment after that, he was gone. And Herod was screaming,
"The child will die! The child will die! And the Antioch ghost with him!"
There were no political considerations to be made. No discussions to be had or advisors consulted. These things would simply come to pass, no matter the cost in men or treasure. They would come to pass, even if he had to kill all the sons of sight of that treasonous blood spilling on his feet, of that treasonous mouth being stupidly opened, of how the Antioch ghost was mocking him. And so Herod circled, playing those strange, disconnected noises of his raw throat, while his advisor lay in silence, waiting for his rage to subside, for they could no more hasten the end of their king's tantrum than make a storm blow itself out before its time. All they could do was take shelter and wait for the clouds to part. When at last they did, Herod slumped into his throne. He was shaking from exhaustion, wincing from the pain in his throat. But he was smiling because the storm had left a seedling in its wake. And I had Chapter 6, A Dream.
Thank you.
would run out of water in a matter of hours. The carpenter and his wife would only slow them down. The baby would die from exposure or dehydration within a day or two, followed by the girl, until all that was left were green madmen having mouthfuls of blood. That was, assuming there was no birth, which was more likely than any other scene. It was bound as a part of the songs and the prided herself on being able to quote these passages better. Thank you.
until, to their amazement, the brass snake slowly uncoiled itself, and while its tail makes his own. A few of them must have been perplexed, terrified by what they saw. What darkness is this? What gods are at work?
Thank you.
however, one little piece of the puzzle that never happened to see. This sent to live in the royal harem when they came of childbearing age. They were forbidden from returning home or taking husbands until they'd first given themselves to live. The Romans called it Ius Primae Noctis, law of the first time. Very few of the Jews would understand such a concept. Even if they did, Judea didn't. There were too many girls and there was only one king. So he would sew it. He ran his spindly fingers through her brown hair, then pulled her closer until he could feel her hurried breath against his face. The fig to Herod's lips.
Enough of that,
he said. He kissed her. He could feel her pulling away as his tongue felt its way around her mouth, felt her struggling against his lips. This was resistance. They all resisted. They all tried to run. But in the end, they were. Two. An ibex looked up, mindlessly gnashing the dry grass in its teeth, the flavorless blades it was somehow compelled to seek out and pull from the hot earth. Something was wrong. It had caught another glue. Felt another glue. Joseph stared back at the house. A long curve had taken note of it. stupid little creatures, sure. But they were the desert developed for hours. And Ubrin was finally in their sights in the distance, though there were a few miserable rocks growing on the region, smooth walls. They would be silent birds. But Joseph, Mary, and the others had hardly passed a word for hours. They were all stiff from a night spent tossing the trees. God knows how long they'd be. 8 hours straight. 10. They'd set out before dawn. And while the sun finally seemed to be falling through the western crater, its rays were still nervous. Had their legs.